now have computer hardware that you can literally wear.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this evening's preview of the 2003 Spring Summerwear Collection from the House of NEC. We call this collection Dressing for Texas. Hiroshi sports the latest information system in a stunning yellow and black ensemble. CD-ROM shoulder pads are back again this year, and Michiko accessorizes with style. Michiko again looking fabulous in an interesting off-the-shoulder data terminal. And this little number is the lap body. It's the laptop you can wear standing up. What you've been looking at is the next generation of personal computers. In the not-too-distant future, human beings will wear the computers they use. We'll choose our hardware, not just for its bits, bytes, and RAM, but, like designer clothing and jewelry, for its look, comfort, and style. It's a revolution whose time has come. You could hardly say computer design has been high on the list of hardware priorities. The technology of the cathode ray tube dictated that computers be box-like and bulky. But flat-screen technology and advances in electronics allowing for shrinking hardware are freeing designers to begin making truly user-friendly computers. The Advanced Design Center of communications giant NEC is way ahead of the pack with their ready-to-wear, well, almost, designer collection of computers that they call human-wear engineering. Number crunches with glamour. The man at the helm of this design push is Hideki Takamasa. He and his team want to take computers off the desktop and out of the office. Using flexible rubber and soft textures, they're creating computers with curves and shapes, configured around the human body and designed for human activities. For the 21st century executive, there'll be no need to stop work just because you've left the office. Let's say you have a letter to get out. With the Porter office, you have three options. You can type it on the touch sensor keyboard, handwrite it on the electronic notebook, or if you need to be hands-free, dictate it using speech recognition directly onto the page. When you're done, a camera located here records the image, and it's then faxed using, say, a cellular network back to your secretary. That leaves you time to make a few extra calls on your way home. The circuitry and battery power for all this is located in tubing running up the spine. Another kind of portable office will be wheeled straight to the boardroom. Easy to store and more comfortable than a laptop, the software will be as flexible as its spine, using integrated circuit cards stored in your wallet. However, not all the wearable computers are for work. Leisure appliances will also become apparel. If you've ever found yourself running after a small child, video camera in hand, then you'll understand the design motivation behind the wear cam. The camera body and lens sit here, just in front of your chest. Aim and focus with the trackball on your hip and view the image on this screen. Camera wobbles aren't a problem because the whole outfit comes with shock cancellation software and magnetic float suspension. Now, if your camera work still doesn't make the grade, even with all these features, don't worry because pictures recorded on an optical disc can be erased. Prototypes are also being designed to tackle difficult conditions. These future computers will be ideal for the weightless environment of space, where anything not attached to the body would float away. Back on Earth, Japan's traffic jams are now so bad that many people have died in the ambulance on their way to hospital. With that in mind comes a medical PC for the postmodern ambulance officer and paramedic. A trackball sensor monitors the patient's vital signs, while a camera is recording surface injuries. Meanwhile, the medic's verbal diagnosis is being matched with a medical encyclopedia stored here on CD-ROM. The prescribed treatment is fed back to the medic through his headset using a voice synthesizer. These goggles are also a mobile satellite station, relaying the patient's condition to a hospital where a doctor can again feed verbal instructions back to the medic at the scene. Most of the technology involved exists today, but before we can slip into something more comfortable computer-wise, the challenge will be to integrate the technologies into a single appliance at a reasonable cost. The other main problem, battery power. Or, more specifically, getting them powerful enough to run the computers and light enough to sit comfortably on the human body. Despite these problems, NEC predicts that as early as 1995, all the best-dressed inventory checkers in warehouses and supermarkets will be wearing this data terminal. As you sweep your arm across the shelves, this sensor reads the barcodes. They can also be entered via touchpads on your forearm. That information is stored on an optical disc carried in the chest plate, and the user can read that information off the LCD screen. It's hands-free stock-taking. Most of these models won't be available until early next century, but it's shaping up to be a future in which fashion victims make fashion statements by how they wear their computers.